Hi again, it's Peter from DIY Full Range Hi-Fi Speakers in Sydney, Australia. Here's just a few photos from the final assembly of the Frugalhorn Pluvia 7 Mark Audio driver assignment, which I was fortunate to be involved in this year. So yeah, we put a bit of polyfill in and around the speaker mounting point at the top, on the sides and around the back of the speaker mounting area, and then some bulk filler up in the narrow part of the taper and also down the wide part of the taper, just with a gap at the bottom leading to the rear port. So there it is, clamped up and glued on the workbench. Put some binding posts, which I picked up fairly inexpensively from eBay. I think there's an image of them. They're fairly long shank, so that can penetrate through the 15 mil thick plywood. I think they were about $15 the pair. I never use them with banana plugs, but some people like to do that. You can see the veneer on the front. It's a piece of brush box, I think, and came up very well. It's actually a thicker piece, which I split down the middle with a very big bandsaw at my woodwork club. And it's kind of a mirror image because the two pieces came from one. And if you look closely, you can see the matching nail holes and blemishes in the grain. So a couple of other things I wanted to mention were there is no nails or screws in this. It's all Ultra Bond 2 glue. And because of the construction, it's really, really solid. Also, the finish, I use a food safe oil because I get that for free from my woodwork club. And beeswax. It's like a 50-50 mix. I warm it up so the beeswax melts, rub it on, and then wipe off the excess. I thought it came out pretty well, pretty happy with the finish. Gives a nice matte sheen and brings out the grain. Really sensational. It's a totally clear finish. Here's the video.
Pretend I can always leave. Free to go whenever I please. But then the sound of my desperate
one of my favourite artists, Tina Arena, and I was really happy with the way they sounded. Terrific bass for the size of the cabinet, and really good little drivers, great high range, and yeah. So, look, the only real drawback with these, I found, was the packaging. Oh, my goodness. So hard to package up to send to Melbourne. But if that's the only criticism, then, yeah, I'll definitely make some of these again if someone can come and pick them up from my place. Thanks. That's it. Thanks for listening, and thanks for watching if you got through to this far, and all the best. Take care. Bye.